Awesome. Great music. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it. I am Brian Payne. I'm the president and CEO of the Central Indiana Community Foundation. And we at CICF have this incredible privilege of supporting the Herbert Simon Family Foundation and the Herbert Simon Family Fund at CICF and Herb's incredible vision for our community and his kids' incredible visions. It's an incredible family with a huge heart for philanthropy, and we have the great pleasure of supporting them and helping them make their big dreams come true. And Rachel Simon, one of Herb's daughters, this is one of her big visions, the public collection. This was Rachel's idea, and we've been having a great time at CICF trying to support that, along with Art Strategies and Mindy Taylor Ross and the Indianapolis Public Library and Well Done Marketing. And it's been a great team, but it's really Rachel's big vision, big idea, and we'll tell you more about that in a second. I want to acknowledge the fact that we're so thrilled that so many people are here, and we are very thrilled that Herb Simon himself, who, you know, has activities all over the world, made a special point to support Rachel, to support this vision. So Herb, thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate that. And our own great mayor, Greg Ballard. Mayor Ballard, thank you so much for being here to help with another fantastic launch of great things going on in the city of Indianapolis under his leadership. CICF and Herb Simon and his family, we share a passion. This is why I actually get to be the MC this afternoon, is that we share a passion about quality of life initiatives, about the importance of libraries, and the importance of literacy and education of all kinds. And also, the Herbert Simon Family Foundation and all of his kids have a great, great passion for social justice and making sure that every person has equal opportunity to live the American dream and to access education and access great works of art and great works of literature. With that, I'm going to introduce Mindy Taylor Ross, who's going to tell you a little bit about the artists that are involved and how this came together from an artistic perspective. Mindy Taylor Ross of Art Strategies.
Good afternoon. Thank you for channeling the weather gods. We are very grateful for that. As Brian said, my name is Mindy Taylor Ross. I'm an independent art consultant, and I have a company based here in Central Indiana called Art Strategies. I've been very pleased to serve as the art consultant on the public collection. Would all of the commissioned artists and creative professionals involved in the 9 commissioned Bookshare stations please come up here and join me, just kind of fan out if you will, and also representatives from each of our 8 partner locations. And if you could try to buddy up sort of artists to location, it'll make it a little bit easier. Before I start, I do want to thank Rachel Simon, the Herbert Simon Family Foundation, and the Central Indiana Community Foundation for this opportunity. I am grateful. So the Public Collection is a new public art and literacy project in the city of Indianapolis. Its goals are to increase access to books, foster a deeper appreciation of the arts, and to raise awareness for educational justice in our community. I want to mention that to open the public collection, a deliberate decision was made to focus on artists with a connection to Indiana. Many artists were considered, and through a curated process that considered many possible artists and many possible community installation sites, we ended up with 9 projects, all of which were conceptualized and created by artists and creative professionals who currently live in the state of Indiana. Each project is site-specific. Not only did artists design with a specific physical space in mind, but they had to sensitively consider the mission of each site as well as the audience that uses it. I want to share with you one of the statistics that was shared with me when I was approached by Rachel and the partners to work on this project. In middle-income neighborhoods, the ratio of books per child is 13 to 1. In low-income neighborhoods, the ratio is 1 age-appropriate book for 300 children. 1 age-appropriate book per 300 children. One of the authors of this study, Susan B. Newman, was quoted as saying, "Access to books and educational material is the single biggest barrier to literacy development in the United States. If we can solve the problem of access, we will be well on the road to realizing educational parity, a goal which has eluded this country for generations." Since I am an art consultant, I also want to mention that a recent study by Americans for the Arts demonstrated that involvement in the arts is linked to higher academic performance, increased standardized test scores, more community service, and lower dropout rates. These cognitive and developmental benefits are reaped by students regardless of socioeconomic status. It is now my pleasure to introduce you to the artists and projects that compose the public collection. Please note that each project is planned to remain in its space for 2 years, so these projects will remain through August of 2017. So here we are, our smallest public collection project. Obviously kidding. This is Monument by Brian McCutcheon. It was fabricated by his company with Randy Domick, Indianapolis Fabrications, and at 80 feet long and 14 feet high, it is the largest and most ambitious project in the collection. It makes formal reference to civic monuments with a twist of being modernized by color, material, and separation from a building. The Lending Library supports an 1894 Mark Twain quote that was written during the same time period as the creation of the Soldiers and Sailors Monument. The quote reads, "A public library is the most enduring of memorials, the trustiest monument for the preservation of an event, or a name, or an affection." Cue sirens. "For it, and only it, is respected by wars and revolutions and survives them." Brian, can you give a wave? We would like to thank the City of Indianapolis. We would like to thank Anthem, Jose Tomas, and Terry Gardner, who are out here. Thank you somewhere for your support, for being a great neighbor. Thank you. Just down Market Street, we have Harvesting Knowledge by Brose Partington at City Market. The sculpture is designed to look and act like agricultural equipment. By digging books out of the earth, our kids finally call this the book Ferris wheel. The piece represents the industrialization of agriculture, and it relates it to the industrialization of publishing. The sculpture represents the viewer's ability to pick information much like food and to harvest knowledge. Rose Partington and Stevie from City Market, we thank you very much for your efforts. Down the street, another way, is Topiary by Eric Norgelin. It can be found on the Indianapolis Cultural Trail off the corner of Virginia Avenue and Pennsylvania Streets. Eric's sculpture is a series of linear vine forms that suggest growth and development, a kind of topiary composition that wraps around existing plant beds on the trail. I want to thank Eric Norgelin, and I want to thank Karin Haley of Indianapolis Cultural Trail, Inc. for their partnership on the project. At Eskenazi Health, you can find Nautilus by Katie Hudnall. The body of this piece is loosely derived from the image of a boat on water, and it's designed to remind the viewer that books and education in general can be a form of transportation. Books can take us to other places and times. They can offer solace and distraction and arm us with the tools and information we need to solve problems in our daily lives and to make us more empathetic creatures. I want to thank Katie Hudnall for her amazing effort on this piece, and our friends from Eskenazi Health, Matt Gutwein, Dr. Lisa Harris, Michael Kaufman, and Richard McCoy. Now, our northernmost partner, the Indianapolis Museum of Art. We were very fortunate to place two projects as part of their ArtX program, which is curated by Scott Stulen. It is an innovative participatory engagement program that is drawing new audiences to our art museum. The first project at the IMA is entitled Cool Books, Food for Thought, and it was created by Tom Terlemke in collaboration with master woodworker Michael Harrigan. I love this project because it places a seemingly familiar object in an institutional setting. It is amazingly crafted. You have to go check it out. Imagine the magic visitors experience when they approach a stunningly crafted, very mid-century mod wooden refrigerator in the lobby of an art museum. When they open the door, the light goes on, illuminating that the fridge contains not food for our bodies, but food for our minds. The second project at IMA is PlayStation by LaShonda Crow Storm, specifically focusing on those little people whose hands we want to fill with books. LaShonda has created a mobile library for children composed of three icons of childhood play: a radio flyer wagon, Legos, and a chalkboard. Upon installation, we had the new IMA preschool children playing and grabbing at books, illuminating the power of this installation. Thank you, Tom, Michael, LaShonda, Scott, our friends at the IMA. The Answer Is in the Question by Phil O'Malley can be found at the Mary Rigg Neighborhood Center on the southwest side. It serves approximately 250 people a day. The center commits to help, serve, and connect neighbors to additional resources. It supports learning, work, and community opportunities to help those who want to improve their situation today and take steps towards a better tomorrow. Phil's designed Bookshare stations in the shape of life-size question marks, and it has become a mascot for the idea that knowledge is available at our fingertips if we ask questions and seek answers. I want to thank Phil and Clark and Kimberly from the Mary Rigg Neighborhood Center. And at number 8, since Rachel is a graduate of the Heron School of Art and Design at IUPUI, it was important to her to have one of the project sites as a professional practice site for a student working towards their Master's of Fine Art. After holding an internal competition at Heron, we selected The Evolution of Reading by Kimberly McNeilan for White River State Park. This project takes the form of a modern cave that creates a unique educational experience about the history of reading and writing. I want to thank Kimberly and Bob and all of our friends at White River State Park. This is the only project you can't see yet. We have to wait till the fall when Heron is back in session, so look for that in the next 30 to 60 days. Thanks, Kimberly, and thanks, White River State Park. Thanks, Bob. And last but not least, I want to ask the artist Stuart Hyatt and the architects Janice Schmitzu and Josh Kogeshall of C plus A Architecture Studio to come to the mic with Teresa Wessel, the executive director of Horizon House. No one can talk about this project better than they can.
Okay. Oh, hello. I'm Stuart Hyatt. When Mindy asked if I would speak here, I didn't really know what to say. So in the spirit of literacy and in the spirit of our project, I've written a poem for you. And Mindy, this invitation to speak, you may regret that very shortly. I've never done this before, so here goes. Can you hear me? Okay. It started with Mindy, who made my connection to this bold new idea called the public collection. A chance to design a book sharing station and to make public art more than mere decoration. It was a bit mysterious, but I do trust Mindy. I mean, she's done like half the cool stuff here in Indy. But first, I learned that I had to compete for the job at Horizon House on Washington Street. What is Horizon House? Do you really not know? It's a place that helps people to heal and to grow, and such a great site for people who need a refuge of sorts to recharge and to read. But first, I needed help. Who am I to design this? I had a small contract. Should I really sign this? Where do I start and what to draw next? So I called the smartest, most humane architects. Joshua and Janice. So talented and great. They once were my teachers way up at Ball State. I really need help. I can't work by myself to somehow combine table, bench, and bookshelf. I told him, come quickly, it's getting quite late. If this inspires you, please, let's collaborate. So we worked together and assembled a crew of folks that are no different from me and from you. Fellow neighbors that needed some work and direction, so we hired them on to the public collection. Manuel mastered the planer and installed the floor. Gary did everything we asked and more. Sam drove the truck all over town. Donald made us laugh when we were feeling down. Melvin sanded surfaces to a perfect sheen, while Victor always kept the job site clean. We had to cut thousands of pieces of wood. Most didn't quite fit the way that they should. Salvaged boards that were covered with nails, bent and broken, but with gorgeous details. Some fit so well, and sometimes we'd just fudge it. I mean, we really, really overshot our budget. The days were hard, challenging, and long, but our team was dedicated, selfless, and strong. At the end of each week, I wanted to complain, but then I dropped off our friends at their tents in the rain. You see, I got to go home to my shower, to my bed, while some on our team have the street instead. So think twice when you see someone asleep in the grass or the couple who live under that bridge overpass. All of us could be just a few steps away from losing it all and living that way. This homeless situation is just so scary, but how can you help? What is even necessary? Just visit Horizon House, see the load that they carry, and ask for Teresa, Leslie, or Mary.
That was a pretty good one.
Horizon House, a breath of fresh air, makes me want to just drop everything and go work there. But a career change now, that just wouldn't make sense. Although I'd drop everything to see Mayor Ballard run against Mike Pence. Didn't know how that was gonna play. But it's the only word that rhymes with sense that came to my mind. Okay. But back to the work and this new public art. We need more projects that have rigor, that are smart. So can we pause with the murals and try some risk-taking? And let's all stop saying creative placemaking. The public collection could be the start of a new compassionate utilitarian art. When I look at most projects built in this town, I see such great ideas that end up kind of watered down. I know, stakeholders, schedules, public rights of way, there's never enough money or hours in the day, but with this collection and the work that's been done, I do get the feeling we've all just begun. So join us after this event and see how our project looks. We'll have plenty of food and, of course, lots of books. We'll be at Horizon House from 2 until 3. Just go out Washington to 1033. It's really beautiful. We can't wait to show it. After all, I'm an artist. I'm clearly not a poet. So, thank you, Mindy and Kelly and Jeff, and thanks to the folks at CICF, and thanks to our neighbors. You now know them by name. Josh and Janice and I will never be the same. And thanks to all of the staff at Well Done and the constant support from Carol Stumm, and of course the folks at the Public Library, and most of all, Leslie, Teresa, and Mary. But before you grow tired of my attempts at rhyming, I need to thank one more person, and that is Rachel Simon. Thank you.
So we didn't know that, but Stuart just gave us the perfect cue to bring on the visionary of this project, the leader of this project, Rachel Simon. Just a little bit more about Rachel. You heard that she's a graduate from Herron. She focused on painting and art history. She's a dedicated advocate for the arts and social justice and how they come together to reinforce each other. She serves on the board of directors of many, many organizations, including the Indiana Pacers Foundation, Global Green USA, and the Indianapolis Museum of Art, and again, many, many others. She's a great representative of this next generation of young visionary leaders in Indianapolis. And someone who's 56 years old, I gotta tell you, this is an incredible group of people that we have in their 20s and 30s and early 40s, every day making our city better, and the vision that they have, the commitment, the passion, the intelligence, the taste. This city is in great, great hands for the future, and it's a great pleasure for me to rub elbows with all of you. Many of you are in this audience, and it's a great pleasure for me to work with Rachel and all that she's bringing from her creativity and her passion to the city of Indianapolis. Rachel Simon.
Thank you all so much for being here. This is way too much flattery. I don't deserve all these accolades. I really don't. They said I had to speak, so here I am. So I'll make it really short. You know, Stuart summed up a lot, and so did Mindy. And I think, you know, the project speaks for itself. But, you know, it's been nearly 2 years, so it's really exciting to stand here and finally present this project. I think the public collection is more than art. It's more than literacy. It's about community building. It's about cultural enrichment. In a technological age that furthers the divide between people and art and people and the written word, it serves as a bridge. I think it's an extension of libraries and museums. It's a way to bring art and literature to you, the people, without any requirements, any prerequisites, and without any social barriers. And to me, that's really exciting. That's something that gets me even more excited than the power of art and the power of literature brought together, which is something even more powerful. So I'm proud also to highlight the talent of such amazing local artists and expose the community to this unique collection of site-specific and functional public works of art, each with its own unique story. So I really could go on forever, but again, I would rather not be talking here at all. I'd rather be thanking everybody because I feel so grateful, and I'm gonna try not to cry. I'm filled with so much gratitude, and I have so many people to thank. So I'll try to get through as many people as possible. The artists, which were all just named, and all the site owners, you guys, I will never be able to express my gratitude. Thank you so much. This has become more than anything I could ever imagine. You've gone above and beyond. Thank you. Thank you so much. Brian Payne, Rob McPherson, CICF, amazing, amazing. Our partner, the Indianapolis Public Library, thank you, thank you, thank you. Well done marketing. My family, I'm not gonna cry, but I am gonna be late because that's typical. My dad, such an inspiration. Thank you so much, Dad. My husband, my little daughter. wipe that face off. I love you so much. The biggest supporters, really. And probably the best team that I could have ever hoped for. Where are the rest of you? Kelly Baumgarn from CICF, Melissa Yoder from Well Done, and Mindy Taylor Ross and Art Strategies. And there are so many people that I haven't mentioned, but again, I could be standing up here all day. I just want everybody to know how grateful I am, and enjoy the art, enjoy the books, and thank you so much. Going to leave it there.
We're so thrilled that Mayor Ballard could join us today, and it's my great pleasure to bring up a mayor who really understands the quality of life and education and literacy go hand in hand, and has done a great job in his 7.5 years here as mayor of Indianapolis. Mayor Ballard, thank you for being here.
Thank you. I find that if I don't come down to the circle for four or five days, I miss something. Where did this come from?
It is amazing.
Just so you know, be careful of this particular sector of it because it has Stephen King and Anne Rice in there. So this is the section where you don't want to read the book alone at night in a spooky place. But I want to thank, obviously, Rachel and Brian Payne and the artists, the tenants that have been that have put all this together. It is amazing when you look at it, and something like this just adds to the city when somebody comes downtown Indianapolis or goes to these other places where they are. They always say, "Gee, what is that? What kind of city is that that would do something like that?" That is what Brian was talking about, the amazing people that we have in our city, the 20-somethings, the 30-somethings that are coming up in the city are truly remarkable, and we're so lucky to have them here. I particularly want to thank Jackie Needus. I'm in the habit of doing that quite a bit because the outreach for the library throughout the entire city of Indianapolis has been so strong over the last few years under her tenure, and I just want to thank her for doing all of that. And making sure that literacy is important in the city of Indianapolis, and that every child in this city has the opportunity to grow through books. And she's done that as best as anybody I can ever see. So I want to thank everybody for coming out today. Another beautiful day, obviously, but it's a lot. This is what partnerships do for a city when things like this occur. So thanks, everybody, for coming out.
Well, Mayor Ballard already mentioned the great leadership we get from Jackie Needus, who's the CEO of the Indianapolis Public Library. From our perspective at CICF, we're so lucky not to only have a great library, but a visionary library leader and team that's re-envisioning what libraries are and how they serve community in the 21st century. And our library, under Jackie's leadership, is at the forefront of that revisioning, reconnecting, in all of America. So we're very, very happy that Jackie Needus and her team decided to partner on this, and that Jackie's here with us today. Jackie Needus.
Well, at the public library, we collect poetry. We don't write it. So we're going to want to get a copy of that one. That was really fun and so on target. So much of the great things that your public library has been able to do in the last 6 or 7 years have been done in partnership with CICF and the Simon family. And I cannot thank you all enough. Your vision in all supporting our early childhood work has been awesome. It has really allowed us to penetrate the world of early childhood education and make a real difference. And now you have also allowed us to activate one of the goals of our strategic plan, which was to infuse materials across the community to increase access to reading materials. And we wanted to do that, but alone we didn't have a chance of doing it right. Now, with this kind of leadership, it's not just happening, but it is happening with energy and creativity and an amazing set of partners. And so we are most grateful for that kind of inspiration and support. We have an obligation now as your public library to make sure that the energy and creativity that has gone into delivering this to the community will be maintained, and that is a pledge that we make to all of you in the community. The library has pledged to take care of these collections just as we take care of all of our collections across the city. And at our branch libraries, wherever there is a nearby public collection, the staff of that branch library will be caring for it. They will be checking on it regularly. They will be restocking the materials as they are borrowed by folks in the community to read. They'll be collecting your donations and recycling them back into the public collection. And so the folks at the Central Library in West Indianapolis and East Washington, Spades Park, Flanner House, Fountain Square, and our outreach department each have adopted one of these collections and will fuss over it and take care of it for the next couple of years. So we look forward to this. I do want to thank all the library staff under the leadership of Laura Johnson, who delivered on this amazing idea in rapid fire time. I think we put to shame any concepts that government cannot be responsive, because when we saw an idea this cool, we knew we had to get in gear. And I want to compliment our staff for having done so. But most importantly, I want to compliment the Simon family and CIC PCF for recognizing that we could be a good partner, and we pledge to take care of these for the next couple of years. Thank you.
Rachel and the mayor and others have been very kind to mention CICF and Rob McPherson and Brian Payne, but really what Rob McPherson and Brian Payne did so brilliantly on this project was hire Kelly Baumgarten a number of years ago and partner her up with Rachel Simon and Mindy Taylor Ross. But Kelly and Rachel are a dynamic duo, and we want to bring Kelly up here because she has a special little gift for Rachel. So, Kelly.
Thank you, Brian. I promise I'm one of the last talking heads of today. And we have to thank Anthem for being such a great partner and allowing us to stand on their front steps, post things up in their window, and be here today. So a huge thank you to Anthem for that. I have the pleasure, and I do mean the pleasure, of working with a lot of families and helping them see their philanthropic dreams happen within Indianapolis and across the country. One of the most generous and gracious families I have had the opportunity to work with is the Herbert Simon family. And so when I started working with Rachel, I went back and looked, and it was May 4th, 2013. She sent me an email that said, "Will you check out this link in the New York Times? I think the Herbert Simon Family Foundation should do something like this in Indianapolis. I have some ideas." So because of that email and because of those ideas and because of her vision, we're standing here and we're looking at these amazing structures, and hopefully you will be able to visit all 9 of them around the city over the next couple of years. I think I speak on behalf of Melissa, Mindy, and I that this has been an amazing process, an amazing team, and we love the vision and the leadership of Rachel. So we have a small token of our appreciation for her. So would you please come up here and get some flowers? Thank you. Thank you so much to Rachel and the support of her family for making this happen in Indianapolis.
So now you can take a book or leave a book.
too many compliments. It's overwhelming. Again, thank you. None of this would be possible without, this is the true definition of collaboration. And while we're up here, I promised Zara she could say something. She's gonna be upset. Say something. Say hi. Okay, on that note, I kind of forgot to mention that my earliest memories not only are of drawing everywhere, on everything, all the time, but also of going to the bookstore with my dad. And that's still a regular occurrence. And I think that's something that really inspired this project. And that's a joy that I hope can be shared with you through the public collection. And so I just wanted to again say thank you to my dad and my daughter for being inspirations. While we're up here, I could talk all day. I'll stop. Thank you so much. I'm so humbled, really. All right, no, run off.
Thanks to all of you for being here, all your great support, all the great community that we all get to experience every day. Check out a book, read a book, check out the art. It's amazing. Have a great day. Thanks again.